Hey everybody, welcome back to Chrono Trigger.
Yep, we're back.
We are back, and we're going to be doing a little bit of item collection at the start of this, and we might be fast-forwarding, I don't know, but at least for the beginning, I'll show you
some tips and tricks. Tips and tricks.
But also, I did a tiny bit of grinding, accidentally got confused on Chrono because I was mostly focusing on her to get her to learn Charm. That's the thing I really wanted, because that's going to come in handy pretty soon.
Steal from enemies.
So, and also to save some time, starting us here, because now with the fully charged pendant, we can start opening these boxes here.
Yep.
However, I don't necessarily want to open these yet, because what you want to do is activate it and then say no.
No.
And this isn't me joking around. This is actually an important bit.
You have to say no, right?
You have to activate
it
and
like
say
just
no.
Just leaving it alone. Huh. Okay.
So that's only to this section in this town. And look, one of our decisions has come to fruition. We could technically go in there, but that would be dumb. So
it would be very difficult.
It would be doable
if you could do it.
It would be doable, but it'd be better for later. And here's one we can just pick up. Got a magic ring. And moving on. I don't remember if there's any in the, Oh, yeah, there is. There is one. Not in this town, because this town disappears. So, going on up. We'll go to the castle in a minute. I think it's in the inn. I believe. Yes.
Yeah. There's a bunch all over.
I think this is one that reacts, but I'm going to save just in case. Oh, man. Damn, I can't. Alright, I should have. Oh, you may have one inside. Okay, this is one that reacts. No. Because there's... Because I'm trying to think if there's, like, one that, like, if you get in the past, it disappears in the future.
Uh-huh.
Because obviously, if it's gone, it's gone.
Uh-huh.
And there's one in the castle that we can't get now in the present, but we can at least activate it. We need to do the, one of the later side quests to really get full access to the castle later.
Okay.
But we also should probably check on the king. And bring Frog along. For some of the dialogue. Because the king has recovered! Everyone's okay!
Yay.
I didn't know we're alive, so you're alive!
That back of that chair is really high.
And it's bigger than the queen's.
Yeah.
Compensating?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
How's he? What made it without you?
Washington Monument, Clinton Monument.
The kingdom. We're all in this together. Frog, thanks again. You deserve the title of knight.
This
of course he bows.
Was not such precious words on me.
Frog! So you're teaming up with Chrono and the others. You've done a fine job. Please remain with us as long as you wish.
Ellipses. My heart is glad. Thank you, my liege. My liege. So, you saved the day.
Yep.
I'm gonna whip up a cake. Magus's troops, Frog, you're magnificent and green.
Thank you there.
Mm-hmm.
So, good old humble Frog. Anything you gotta say?
Thanks will carry over the generations of his family that all look like old men.
Funny how that doesn't change. Is it this way? I do not remember. Yes, it is. So we can activate this one.
How many of those do you have to do that to?
I think this shows three.
Okay.
I could be wrong, but...
Yeah, it's fine. As long as you get the things you want. If you miss a few,
Actually, it was four, wasn't it? Yeah, it was four. Because there was two in the bottom town. One on the inn here. Oh, that's a trap.
It's a shiny, shiny trap.
Let's go, shiny! Alright, so that is, I believe, it for here for right this second. And there's actually a couple things. Oh no, I missed one. Because I'm stupid.
Nah.
There's one in the forest.
Forest?
Yeah. This forest that was just in. That I completely forgot about.
To the left?
To the right.
Oh, to the right. Oh, yeah, I remember now. That one where you escaped into the gate and there was a box.
Right. Well, this just has a dead end, but these two boxes here don't correlate.
Oh. Huh.
So I can just open it.
Okay. Yeah, there's no clearing.
Yeah, and this one is just dead end. Okay, now we've got what we need for here for now. We will need to come back to this area to get them, because you can actually kind of mess with time a little bit, but we'll get to that. So the present is where our next destination is. But we're actually going to go to the monster town first. I forget the name of it. But monster town will do. We can get a kick-ass sword. Or helmet. Depending on your choice.
Doesn't everyone, like, pick the sword, though?
Well, it's a good idea to get sword your first playthrough.
Well, I say that because it's, like, it's in everyone's nature to get the, like, the attacky thing. Like, oh, goody, this keeps me safe. Like, you want the thing that does big damage and, like, it's cool, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And it kind of reminds me of, like, in Fate Stay Night, where, like, Saber or, Artorias... Like, Merlin's like, I got you these cool things. I got you this sword that can destroy any enemy stronghold. It's called Excalibur. And I got you this sheath called Avalon. It will protect you from any harm. Which do you like better? And Artorias, she answers, I like the sword better. He's like, you idiot! No! He's like, if you have the sheath, you're invincible!
So...
Like, of course you answer the sword. Always with the sword with you children.
It shine like star.
Shine bright like a diamond.
We are breaking this seal. This ancient seal.
Shine bright like a... Wait, what's in here?
You'll find out.
No, spoil me. Even though I could just wait a few seconds. It looks like a tablet. With inscriptions. No, wait, no. That's just...
It's just a floor.
Ah, two boxes.
And a new.
Ah, a new.
And this counts as our present day new. The seal has been broken. I'll give you the treasure of the Guru of Reason. To the right is a weapon which increases strength. To the left is protective gear which will guard your life. Choose whichever you feel you need. Take it with you.
But you can't have both.
Cannot have both. It's a long time. Balthazar, I shall see you shortly. Well, he died.
Bye. No, he didn't die.
He teleported away. Anyway.
News don't die.
So this is, I think, the safety helm, which automatically casts Protect on you. It's actually a very, really, really good...
I wish it was just that red weird hat thing they wear.
That would be awesome. But this is the better choice.
Yeah.
For now. Got the Swallow. Which is an odd name for a sword, but it's blue.
It's named after a bird.
It is. And it's, I think, Chrono's either second or third best sword.
Ah.
So, let's see, 106 to 148, yeah. That was a major strength increase.
Chrono's a beast.
And it also increases speed, so he's now going to be super quick.
And super strong.
In fact, he's now the fastest person.
Oh, what a surprise. Yeah. Chrono was always pretty fast to begin with.
Yeah, so that was the better choice for your first playthrough. Your second playthroughs, you'll already have it with New Game Plus.
And you said you'd give that home to, like, Luca, huh?
Yeah, you'd give it to Luca. Well, I should actually put back in my party so to see if her dad has any new gear for her.
Her Faja.
And...
Her what now? Her Faja. Her what? Her dad. Her Faja.
Oh, we actually want to go through
father.
The cave.
is it the Hecarim cave?
Yes.
Why?
There's another box.
Oh. Wow, you have a good memory of these. I imagine you as a baby Andrew was like always... always like meticulously remembering their locations because it must have been a pain to, like, you know, not know where they are. This was like early internet, so it's not like there was many walkthroughs. Oh. The GameFAQ community was not strong as it was. It is present day.
I actually had the strategy guide for this.
Ah,
not because I necessarily needed it, but
need it.
But back in the day, and maybe we'll do like a separate video because I have a couple. Here it is. Like, the strategy guides, like, the official strategy guides for some of these games were, like, really freaking nice.
Really cool. I always liked the Pokemon ones. I had both the original and the yellow version strategy guides, and they were just really useful.
Gosh. Oh, so that one was a two for one. A twofer.
Yeah, so I'm guessing Wall Ring is really defensive and good. Dash Ring is speed.
Yeah.
Or probably. No, I'm wrong. The Dash Ring is actually very protective, or the Wall Ring makes you faster.
We can check, but.
Trollolo. Yeah, okay, come take a little dip with us, Ayla.
Yeah, get that already revealing outfit more wet.
Actually, no, she's probably wearing like Reeboks or some shit now, because we've given her modern gear. Like this cave woman with like, you know, like her pumps.
Nothing new.
Air Force Ones. But just that, the bikini stays.
Well, speaking of her attire, we can actually have a...
The bikini, yeah.
Oh, now
yeah.
That we're here. Hey, Mom, look what I found. Gracious, who are you? Me, Isla. Isla, a young lady doesn't dress like that, dear. But Isla like. Say, yes, ma'am. Chrono strong. Chrono mother strong, too. I love they put that stuff in. It's so fantastic.
All right, so... Did we already get what she says with Robo? You don't have to go back. I'm just wondering.
I think we did. So...
Oh, yeah, she was like, oh, well, you're a strange friend, but you're a friend nonetheless of Chrono's.
Yeah, I was like, oh, you're strange, but very polite. Yeah, what's inside?
Open it.
The blue vest is powered up. Now I found the blue mail. Let me move.
What?
Okay.
Oh, okay.
For a minute, it got me stuck there for a second. That was weird. So now we gotta head back down here to get the ones. In here. So we've already changed his tune. So he's now nice. And Nina, my cat, is inspecting James.
He's just sniffing me. He tickles. She likes sniffing. Sometimes I think your cat's like a dog trapped in a cat body.
Well, she does fetch every now and then.
I mean, I guess she's smelling the scent of tires. Is it fascinating?
Alright, so, that's everything in the present day, except for the thing in the castle, which we can't get, which I think is the red mail.
I'm guessing color-wise, like what, blue one protects you against water, red one protects you against fire?
Right, not only does it protect you, it absorbs it.
Oh, yeah, yeah, these are the absorption ones, which are really good. If you have, like, prior knowledge of what you're going to be facing,
yeah,
it's
these,
like, it's like nothing.
This will come in super handy in a bit. Probably not this episode or even the next, because it'll take us a while, but... You remember that golem we fought?
Oh, he's gonna be.
We're gonna fight. We have to fight two.
Yeah.
At the same time.
Oh, those are gonna be super helpful. Yeah.
So all you gotta do is slap on those armors, and you're good. In fact, I think.
Well, doesn't he have a third element? Or,
Well, they will. They'll counter whatever you throw at them.
Okay.
So whatever element you use, they'll counter. And I believe there's a helmet we can get that'll reduce the amount for water. So I think the best thing to do is have... Because we can actually go back to the ancient... To medieval times.
Yeah.
Not the restaurant. Screw it, may as well, just while I'm talking about it.
I see what you mean. Like, you can give one person the helm and the other person the vest.
Well, we can actually... As I said, when we can screw with time a bit. Kind continuity is... Now that I've gotten the upgraded versions of the males...
You
they're
can
mine.
Get the weenie versions.
They're not going to disappear. So I can go and get the not-so-great versions... And they'll still absorb or reduce the amount of damage.
Yeah.
So, it's sort of like, alright, pick one element, and I think it's usually just going to be water. And they can't touch you.
Dun-dun-dun-dun. Dun-dun-dun-dun.
Can't touch this.
Ball is life.
Did you ever, have you, this is probably, it's an internet thing, but you probably heard at least one of their songs, but there was a... Have you ever heard of a band called Group X?
Nope.
I think the only thing like they were probably most famous for was they did a somewhat a cappella version of the Mario theme. It was like an animation on Newgrounds back in the day. But it's these two dudes doing like a Middle Eastern-ish fake accent to sing. I'll let you listen to something in the between. And it's intentionally like dumb and funny, but they did a parody of Can't Touch This, and it's called it Don't Touch That.
I think I might have heard of this.
It's like, don't touch that, then yeah. Can't have it. It's that sort of accent.
Sounds kind of familiar, yeah.
You know, or somewhat racist, but...
houses, take your stuff.
No, they're not reacting.
They never question it. Like there's this box we cannot open, just sitting here.
I mean, it's a pretty box. Can you let me... Game was glitching out on me for a second.
Nah, that was just a child blocking your way.
As children do. Alright, so... our next destination is the future. Because there's a couple doors we can open up. And then, on to our actual objective.
Okay.
It's like, guys, really, just let me through. You're not going to stop me now.
Yeah, I kind of wish that Mother / Earthbound thing was in play. It's like, these guys are so worthless. They're not even worth your time.
I'm getting some tonics out of it. Tonics I don't even use.
Yeah. It wouldn't even be worth it. You need like a mid tonic.
Yeah, because I think they only, restore 50.
You can always use them in bulk.
I suppose, if I'm... in a pinch.
No, I meant like on the field, use them in bulk.
Oh. Let's see. No, not that one. Oh, yeah, we can go here. This was the, it's the soul here just to get this chest. Because I can't leave. Because they've blocked it off. Anyway, and this is Power Ring.
Which is going to equip a bunch of good stuff on everyone, huh?
We can. I mean, ultimately, I usually just give them, like, gold studs to reduce their magic cost.
Yeah. I would do that, too.
But since I'm already kind of doing, like, this, you know, item collection thing, I'm going to spare people the inventory management for now. So I think in one of these, got the wallet, ether, charm top. Yes, that's super important.
For Ayla?
Yes. That increases the charm rate.
Yeah, I took a guess. Yeah.
these
guys needs a wallet or something?
No, I think the wallet just increases the amount of GP you earn.
Oh.
Alright, got a magic tab. Gold stud, sweet. That's super important. In fact... wait, who doesn't have one? You got a silver stud. You're getting a gold one.
Girl, we're gonna upgrade you to gold!
Let's see. Yeah, it turns EXP into G.
Oh.
Gold stud.
I mean, that'd be... like, when your like characters are pretty much maxed out, you just grind for money.
Pretty much. Was that the only gold stud I had? I thought I had one more.
I'm pretty sure that's the only one so far.
No.
I've had all silver.
You get silver
so far.
Then. Does the charm thing have the, no, it just says charm powered up. In the... in the DS version of this.
Yeah.
Which is, as I've said, the sort of definitive version.
It's just like a very revealing top.
It's instead of calling it charm top, it's called alluring top.
Yeah.
Because they're like, well, look, we're not going to hide it. Isla's freaking hot, yeah. So there you go. And we need to go through here just because it's, I think, the faster way to go. couple times.
Oh no. No! You gotta get it back! What will we ever... No!
Not the tonic.
Oh, no! Oh, no. I don't like facing these guys.
Well, they're easy now.
Everyone's gross in the future. Yeah, I know, but... God. I like that detail that they changed the color on Chrono's sword. It's like, little, but it's nice.
Mm-hmm.
Because, like, a lot of RPGs, I always be bummed out, like, your characters never show what they're wearing.
Right.
I guess that's why I like Monster Hunter so much, because that was literally one of the main things. Like, you buy new, things, you see it. It's gonna show up on your character.
Yeah, I definitely appreciate that when they do that in games. I mean, I can understand them not wanting to,
because
it's
a lot of work.
It's a lot of work.
You already make a bunch of, like, items. Now you have to make a bunch of art assets over your characters.
Mm-hmm.
Make sure they don't, like, have some adverse effects, like, causing a glitch. Like, imagine your character wears this one armor that has really big shoulder pads or some shit, and then it just fucks up with doors of certain sizes in the game.
Or if they move, it just sort of glitches, you know, in and out of their arms.
Phases in and out of their arms because of, like, weird modeling issues or whatever, yeah.
Well, I can understand that. And especially when you have character designs like these where it's like...
They're good.
They're super good and you don't want
to
really mess it
up. Yeah, I can imagine people making them really stupid looking. Like, I mean, well, there's a certain charm, like... Like, in Tales of Symphonia, like, they kind of have, like, a bit of a compromise in that, where it's, like, weapons will show up as different weapons, but your characters will pretty much be the same. Like, you'll wear new armor, but their outfits will be the same. But, for very special outfits, then they change the, like, and I mean, like, you have to go out and find them. Like, these are, like, really, like, hidden, like, things.
Yeah.
Like, get your casual clothes for Lloyd Irving. Get your weirdo, like, weird alternate outfit for Rain, which, I don't know, this weird brown outfit that I didn't like. I was like, I'd rather keep her in a scholarly whatever robes.
Yeah, I mean, I guess...
But it's really good.
Yeah. I mean, I guess that's why, like, back in the day, like, I guess even now, to an extent, like, getting, like, alternate outfits for characters
was,
like...
Does the sword just have a high crit rate, or is he still wearing, like, a high crit thingy on him? Or is he just critting because he's Chrono?
I think he's critting just because he's Chrono.
Yeah.
Because Chrono already has a pretty decent amount of, like... From what I remember, he had a decent, like, chance to crit anyway.
Yeah.
But the sword he's got is...
As I mentioned in a very old video of this LP, like, they don't call him, like, high crit Chrono for no reason. Yeah. Oh, yeah, down here was a door.
So down here's
a
door.
Are the sealed doors mainly in the future?
Yes.
I'm trying to think if there's one in, like, any other era. I don't remember seeing one in, like, the past. I mean in the prehistoric era.
No, that wouldn't make any sense.
And it would really stand out.
I mean, the prehistoric era is, like, before all that happened, so it wouldn't make sense.
It'd just be, like, the same door, but it'd just be a stone circle with the Zeal engraving and, like, you know, chiseled on it. Beep, boop, beep, I saw nothing. My eye is searching for intruders. Who's that? Oh, I did a bad job self-destruct. Power tap.
Sweet.
You got power tap.
Lumen robe.
Hit
ring.
It's the ring. It's the ring that bald fucking the games was. Agent 20, Agent 46, whatever the fuck. I don't... Like, with the number shit, like, there's also, like, a soldier in Overwatch that's, like, Soldier 47 or 79 or whatever, some number. I'm just like, why? I already pictured in my head. He was, like, the 46th soldier, and he's the only one that survived. The others got bored and left.
They went for sandwiches and didn't
Never
take me.
Came back. They were really disappointed. I mean, no, I shouldn't be too hard on it. Like, it can actually be kind of cool if done right, the whole number thing. In fact, Will did it with one of his Pokemon. I was facing him again, and he just fucking destroyed me. But he had a Reuniclus or whatever. It's like the little soul Pokemon that evolves into, like, a big, like, alien baby thingy.
Yeah, yeah.
And that thing is a really good wall, both special and physical wall. That's its big stats. And that's what Will named it. He named it, like, I think he named it, it's something along the lines of like Experiment 44 or something, because that was the 44th one he made. So he was just naming them like Experiment 1, Experiment 2, 3, 4, 5, and it took him 44 tries to finally get like one with like perfect IVs.
That's funny. Will's a funny guy.
Oh, yeah, and his fucking Gengar named Rick Ghastly. I was like, oh, it's too strong. And he has a Tyranitar named Reptar. I was like, okay, that's pretty good.
And enough time has passed in this game where the old man...
He gone.
He's gone.
He gone.
What do you got to say, Sleeping New?
Probably just Z. Oh, wait, you woke him up. That should change. We know what he is now. Whatever.
The professor's programming was, in a sense, his own eulogy. Soon, I too will be able to sleep forever.
Five ever.
But first, there's one thing I must do. Program error. My memory banks have failed. You had one job.
They can be programmed.
You had one job.
They can be programmed, huh?
Well, I mean, that much as might be a robot in the shape of a new.
Oh yeah. That's an idea.
Or like a new android hybrid.
Follow the sparks.
To those who opened the door, I'm Balthasar. I'm mispronouncing his name horribly.
No, that's
Balthasar.
Don't worry.
The Guru of Reason.
In fact, mispronounce it more just to piss off the random people that find this video.
I'm Balthasar. I once lived
I'm
in the
Balthasar's. Yeah, Sars.
I'm Bulbasaur.
I'm Bulbasaur.
His name's Bulbasaur. Screw it. I once lived in the Kingdom of Zeal.
A very reasonable pick for a starter, yeah.
A great disaster in Zeal somehow threw me into this era. To my surprise, Lovus exists here, and I suspect in other periods as well. Eons ago, Lovus descended from the heavens. Yes, I know, I saw it. Mm-hmm. Deep
I was there.
I was there!
I even bought the t-shirt.
Well, that reminds me, we gotta go speak to Kino, because he thinks we're dead.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Burrowing deep into the Earth world's core, he began to consume our planets. Excuse me.
Energy!
Do. Lovus appeared briefly when he was summoned away by a mighty wizard who lived in Guardia, near 600. We know who that was. We were there for that, too. In 1999, Lovus claimed this area.
How real was this when you were playing this game? And you're like, 1999, huh?
It was literally like a... When we got to that level, I'm like... So, Lovus, any day now, right?
Like everyone ready? Day of Lovus. Forget that Y2K shit.
It was sort of like not that long ago where the dude was like, it's the, what was it, the Reckoning? No.
Oh. We've lived through so many, like, end time bullshit. Like, I'm just like...
What was it where he was like
the... When the actual apocalypse comes, I'm gonna be like, I'm gonna be fucking jaded and bored. I'm gonna be like, oh, look, the Earth's torn asunder, and the sky's... thundering and ripping apart. Whatever. The odds are against you. The world is in your hands. It's getting older and older. My wings of time.
Wings of time.
Take these broken wings! For the flag! Is that wood? What the fuck is wood doing in this? This is the future. Everything's made of chrome, right?
Pretty.
Yeah.
This must be the invention Bulbasaur spoke of.
You caught yourself good. I'm proud of you.
What, this thing?
Well, like, Ayla.
Well, whatever it is.
And he's like, I don't know either.
Whatever it is, I'm totally going to add fins here and give it a wicked freaking paint job.
So, I'm going to...
Anyway.
Some flames. Let's bail.
Some flames, definitely. Decals.
What is he... Oh, I see.
He's moving up the seats.
I thought that was like a pushy thing, you know, that you put in the back.
Yeah.
You ever see those like ways to like launch crafts from like a carrier? They have like also like a ramp that pushes it.
Scared you, didn't I? It's me, Bulbasaur. I copied my memory into this thing. What do you think? Well, your lack of clothes is disturbing, but
a little bit of me is right here.
Anyway, there's something I need to explain. Namely, how to transcend time. Press the Y button for the time gauge.
Press the Y button to transcend time. Do it now.
Use the L and R buttons to select the era. Oh yeah, before you go, why don't you... Name my machine. That's Stan. Epoch. Hop aboard. No.
Wait, what? Why?
It was actually this.
Oh. Oh, okay.
I got a magic tab.
Cool.
But it's also funny. It's like, hop aboard!
No.
No. You've creeped me out well enough.
Just as you bolt. Now hop aboard!
As follows...
Just mash. Mash, 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 mash,
and Professor's message.
Okay. Alright,
so let's... Let's get on in.
I hope there's a cup holder.
Let's take off.
Mumble, mumble?
Yeah.
That's the machine?
No, that's Bulbasaur.
Oh, I thought that was like the time machine was speaking to you and it was just like...
Let's go to the end of time, shall we?
The ends of time.
I was like, hell yeah! Epoch Alive? Traveling at warp speed!
And they don't have like a canopy or anything.
Epoch capable of this? To us, it just looked like it's staying still. But I guess it is going crazy. Let's talk to the old man.
Man, mad ups on these guys.
He's like, hey! Interesting. So he actually finished the Wings of Time. In fact, gave his life for it. Why not put that device to good use? Take it to the ancient land of magic!
Yay.
Come see me anytime. Think of me as your guide. Alright.
What is that? It's just that green goop that you eat? I always wondered what that stuff is.
Yeah. I don't know. Whatever. It's not important.
Whatever. It's not important. Video games.
So let's actually talk to Kino first before we end the episode, because we're at about the 30-minute mark.
Yeah.
And this is just a little bit of dialogue. Plus, I want to see if the new is showing.
He needs to see his Ayla.
He needs to see his girl. Plus, even though everything looks the same, and we actually don't ever really need to come back here again, technically, they actually do have some dialogue to reflect that winter is coming. It's like, Ayla, okay! Kino, okay! Lava's fall. Reptite's gone. Good. But get cold now. Hunting bad. But Kino, not give up. No worry. Leave to Kino.
Okay.
That's all we really need.
Ayla didn't say anything. Weird.
So now they've asked the
people
from the village.
Ioka village.
So they are now here. But like, white cold stuff fall from sky. What that?
Just start yelling at the snowflake.
Many cloud in sky. No can see sun.
Man. The effects Lavos has had on our planet.
Yep.
It's crazy.
And I don't think he's here yet. I think more time has to pass, but there's a new that shows up here.
Mm.
Yeah, he's usually right here.
Yeah. Okay.
And he lets you rename your characters, and he also gives you an item.
Wow, I didn't know that. I didn't know there was a place where you could rename your characters.
Yep.
I mean, we don't want to, but still.
You don't want to, but still. Anyway, that's really all we can do in this episode. Hopefully you didn't worry too much with the item collection, but it was worth it because we got some really good stuff. And we're going to be tackling the Mountain of Woe, or at least the beginning of, because actually I kind of wanted to keep going a little bit because there's a grinding spot that we need to do.
Yeah.
But, you know what, I might just say screw it and move on. But anyway, that being said, we shall see you guys in the next episode of Chrono Trigger.
See you guys next time.
Laters.